गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर कंप्यूटर क्लास। इन टूडेज क्लास वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट एन अनदर एडवांस फीचर ऑफ एचटीएमएल, दैट इज फॉर्म एलिमेंट। सो व्हाट इज फॉर्म? फॉर्म इज अ कॉमनली यूज्ड ऑब्जेक्ट इन अ वेब पेज दैट इज यूज्ड टू कलेक्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम एप्लीकेंट्स और विजिटर्स ऑफ अ वेब पेज, सच एज नेम, एज, जेंडर, कॉन्टैक्ट डिटेल्स, ईमेल एड्रेस, कॉमेंट्स, फीडबैक्स एंड सो ऑन। इन एचटीएमएल अ फॉर्म टैग इज यूज्ड टू क्रिएट अ फॉर्म इन अ वेब पेज विच इज अ कंटेनर एलिमेंट that contains different elements called controls to collect data. Few examples of controls are text box, check box, radio button, comment button, list box, submit button and so on. So now I will create one form to make you understand how to make form. So let's have a look. Let me open Notepad where I will write HTML code to make a form in a web page. This is Notepad. At first I have to type the basic structure of HTML code. But I have copied that, which I will paste here. See here, title is my page. So my web page title will be my page. Now in between start and end tag of body element, we have to include form element, which is a container element. That means both form start and end tag we have to write here. Form start tag, form end tag. Now in between start and end tag of form element, we have to write code to include different controls for my form. So different controls are text box, check box, password box, radio button, comment button, submit button, etc. So first I will include one text box. For that we have to use an element called input, which takes one attribute type. The value of the type attribute specifies the type of the control. So if I write here text, it will make one text box control, which will accept one single line text from the user. Let me save it. Save. Here in save as dialog box, I have to change the save as type from text documents to all files. And I will save my file on the desktop so that easily I can open that web page. So location I have to change to desktop. Now I will give the name of my file. I am giving page.html as the name of my web page file. Save. See, this is my web page file which took the icon of Microsoft Edge, which is my default browser. I am double clicking on it to open it. See, this is my web page. Nothing is there because in the body section under form element, I have written code to include only one text box. So this is my text box. Click on it. Your cursor will blink inside the text box to accept data from you. I'm writing here some text. This is one line text. When I will click on the submit button of form, this value will be taken from this text box control. Now let me again open the code. Here we have to prompt user what value user will type, otherwise the user don't know what to enter here in the text box. So I'm writing here name. Now user will understand here in this text box he or she has to enter his or her name. And another very important attribute of any input element is name. Name for the name of the element. This name will be used to refer this element to access the value at the server end. Right, I'm giving here the name txt name. So this is text box name. Any name you can give, but remember the name should be meaningful so that we can remember the name to access this control from the server side. Even we can write value attribute also to specify a default value for this text box. Like I'm writing my name. Now in this case, when the form will be open, in this text box, my name will be displayed. If user doesn't enter any value, my name will be taken as value for this text box. Otherwise, user can replace my name with his or her name. Let me show. See now, name, this is the level which indicates that in this text box, you have to type your name. And by default, name is Rupesh Dev, which you can change. Like I am writing here, Rajiv Das. That means now the value of this text box is Rajiv Das. When you will submit the form, this value will be taken. Now next line, I will accept user's password. So for that, how to come to the next line? We will use br element, which is empty element. Password colon. Again, I will use input tag. This is empty element. That's why I have not written any end tag of this input element. Sorry, here the type value will be type. You know that this like silly mistake browser ignores. That's why it has ignored that spelling. Now type equal to, here I will write password. this password for make the input box password box. So this will also looks like text box, but whatever you will type in the text box, for each character instead of character symbol will come, either bullet or star symbol, which will hide the actual text from the user. Here also we need name attribute, name equal to name of this password box. I'm giving pw box for password box. Value obviously we will not give, because what password user will type, that will be taken as value. Let me write br to make a new line after this. Save it, reload the page. Now see, name then password. Let me type one password here, abc123. See, instead of abc123, six bullets appeared. Click on the show button, it will show the password. Again, you can hide the password from user. This password box is not given in your book, but I think it is required to know. That's why I have discussed. Now, next we will learn checkbox. It is used when more than one option is to be selected from a number of options. Now, here also we have to prompt user what user will select from a group of checkbox. I'm writing here competition. List of competition I will write here under this competition tag, from where user can select multiple competitions to take part. Input. Here type value will be checkbox. Next, name equal to name of this checkbox. I am giving chk drawing. And value attribute is very important here. Equal to value. Value means the value which will be taken when user will select this checkbox. Checkbox is nothing but a small square box. When user will click on that, one tick symbol will appear in that checkbox, and again to deselect that you have to click on that. So that tick symbol will disappear from the checkbox. So when you will click on that checkbox, what value will be taken, that we have to write here as the value of this value attribute, because here users are not allowed to type the value. So value we have to specify here. Like here for this checkbox I am giving the value drawing, for drawing competition. And generally for the checkbox, caption comes after the checkbox. So here I am writing drawing, then beer, next checkbox, again one input element. Let me copy this. This is for second competition. This is also type is checkbox, name is chk quiz competition, and value will be quiz. And here also we will display quiz level after the checkbox. Next is recitation. Value will be recitation and label will be recitation. And after that I will include one more input element for the last competition, which is singing competition. So in that case value will be singing and here caption will be singing. Now let me save my file. Reload it. See, now competition, drawing, quiz, recitation and singing. Drawing should come after this competition. So here I have to give one BR element after competition. So where competition I have written here, BR. Save, reload. See, now these are four competition. Either you can take part in one competition or more than one competition. Let me select. In this way you can select. Again you can click on that same checkbox to deselect it. So from a group of checkboxes, we can select multiple checkboxes. This is the feature of checkbox. So why I have made checkboxes? Because users are allowed to select multiple checkboxes from this group of checkbox. Because students are allowed to take part in more than one competition. Like I want to take part in drawing competition and recitation competition. But under recitation competition, if we need to specify the language using which we will recite something, that time we need to include another type of control called radio button, which is also called option button. Radio button is just like checkbox, but here the button will be circular. When you will click on that, one dot will appear inside that button, means it is selected. The main difference between checkbox and radio button is that radio button is used when out of many options, just one is required to be selected. Like Bengali, Hindi, English, you cannot select more than one language. You have to select any one language, either Bengali or Hindi or English, to recite something. So let me open the notepad file again. Here after this recitation, I will include input element, input type equal to, in this case we have to write radio. This is for radio button. Here also we need to specify name and value. Name equal to RB for radio button, RB LANG radio button for language. Now value equal to English. Close it, and after that you write the caption English. Now this way three radio buttons we have to include here. Here it will be Hindi, here also Hindi, then here Bengali, here also Bengali. So caption Bengali, value Bengali, caption Hindi, value Hindi, English caption, value English. So when user will click on the first radio button for English, it will take the value English. When user will click on the last radio button, that is for Bengali, it will take the value Bengali. But see here, the name of these three radio buttons are same, RB Lang, RB Lang, RB Lang. For this all radio buttons you have to use same name. That means all these radio buttons will be considered as one control for which you are taking the value either English or Hindi or Bengali. But if you use different name for different radio buttons, it will allow you to select more than one radio button, which is actually violating the rule of radio button. That's why I have used the same name, because we know any one value will be selected from these three radio buttons. Let me save, reload it. Oh, sorry. Here you have to give another DR element after Bengali. DR. Save. Reload now. Now see, first in this name box, I will type my name. Then in password box, I will type my password. Then competition, drawing, quiz, recitation and singing. More than one we can select. But in case of recitation, when we will select language, any one language you can select. You cannot select more than one language because they have same name. See, I'm clicking on this to select this. But when you will click on this Hindi, the English will be deselected automatically. See now, because only one can be selected from this group of radio buttons. But in case of checkbox, once you click on that checkbox, that is selected. When you will select another checkbox, previous one will not be deselected. Okay. Now at last, we have to add one submit button to submit my form. So for that, what to do? One more input element. Input type equal to submit. And for this submit button, name and value will be submit. Name equal to submit, value equal to submit. This is the button to submit your form. Saving, reload. Now this is the submit button. So after filling your form, when you will click on this submit button, from server side, all the data of these controls will be collected against your response. So this is form. I hope you understood how to make form. So in today's class, we have learned how to make form in a web page. I hope you understood. Now this is your time to read the full chapter thoroughly line by line, and you must do the exercise from this chapter. In my next class, I will discuss the answer of this exercise. Till our next class, bye. Have a nice day.